Let's talk about inserting images and wrapping the copy around them. I'm going to scroll down here, and again, you've got the option to really to upload as many images as you want. You can you get two by default, then you can click on Add Another Item, and that will allow you to continue to add as many images as you want. I'm going to browse, and again, I've got some preset images. So I'm going to pick a headshot here of Dr. Curtis Austin. It's 150 pixels wide. I'm going to upload that. And again, I'm not going to worry just for the sake of expediency of filling out these fields, but I am going to go ahead and try to insert this image. And let me talk just real quickly about the insert options. We've got four different insert options, and we are recommending for portraits that you size them at approximately 125 pixels and then float them either left or right. For landscape images, which again are going to be more horizontal, can run a little bit wider because they're not going to be as deep. Approximately 200 pixels. However, the reality is it is in picking any of these preset sizes, if I want to run Dr. Austin larger than 125 pixels, then I can select the 200 pixel option. And basically what we've set up is that you can run an image up to or equal, or I'm sorry, less than or equal to whatever these preset sizes are. So in this case, This image of Dr. Austin is 150 pixels, so if I select 125 pixels and insert that, scroll back up, look at that, and again, the formatting is not going to show up here, but if I save it, we'll see how it wraps around it and it puts a little border around the image. Okay, now if I click on that and look at the image properties, Drupal has scaled it down to 125 by 167, so it's basically disallowed us from inserting that or from running that at the full 150 pixel width because we selected the 125 pixel option. So let's go back in and delete that. And let's go down here and pick the 200 option, okay, and insert that and save it. And because 150 pixels is less than or equal to, it's going to allow that to be output at a larger size. And if we view the image info, and again, I'm just right-clicking, we can see that it's 150 by 200 pixels. And so that's basically how it works with, regardless of your image size, it's less than or equal to that 125 or that 200 pixel recommendation, and then you either float it or float it right.